Welcome to the series of videos about functional programming in Kotlin with Arrow. Arrow is a library packed with data types and type classes, bringing functional programming to Kotlin. In this video, we are going to learn about the validated data type and what it's used for.
Validated is a data type in Arrow that we use to model when a function may return two kinds of values, which could be considered valid or invalid. As with either, it can be one or the other. Validated is frequently modeled as an algebraic data type in the same way as we saw in option and either. Validated has two cases. Algebraic data types are modeled in Kotlin with sealed classes. Validated has two possible values, either an invalid or a valid. In the invalid case, we usually encode a non-expected value. In the valid case, we encode what we can call the happy path. This is important because validated is like either, right biased. This means that most of the functions like map, filter, will operate over the valid case. We have two main constructors to work with validated. The invalid constructor placed on the left. As we have seen before, we are modeling unknown errors without using exceptions and putting that on the left side, because our computation is mostly going to happen on the end, which is the right side. This right side can be placed with the valid constructor, which allows us to bring values into the context of validated placing them on the right. Arrow provides an extension syntax for validated. We can easily leave values to the left, invalid, and right, valid cases, provided the receiver declares a type, in which we know that the other case is. Usually, when the value is invalid and stored in a list, we want to ensure that it is non-empty. This is pretty obvious, as we want something stored in it that will describe what error occurred. This can be ensured by using the arrow non-empty list type. It ensures that the list that it wraps around will always have at least one element. Non-empty list and validated can be used together, and in fact, that combination is very common. Thus, Arrow provides us already with a type alias along with helpful functions that we can use to operate on this kind of constructs. We can transform the inner contents of validated with several bulletin functions, such as fall, get or else, or map. This might be familiar for you at this time because we saw the same functions in option or in either. This is part of Arrow's unified model of programming. We take all the functional combinators and try to apply them as many data types as possible, so that all of them share the same API. We can extract validated inner values by using Kotlin when expressions. In this case, you can see how the result value will be of type validated. It can be easily placed on our own expressions, and then we can branch out logic based on the valid and invalid cases. An easier way to deal with this case is using for. Fold allows us to pass two functions. The first function addresses the invalid case. Here, we are saying that if we find a known error, we should return 0. The second argument is a function that addresses the valid case. Here, we have the chance to transform the inner contents of valid. A concretion to the previous fold is get or else. In get or else, we are just simply providing the function that addresses the invalid case. Here, we are saying that if it's a known error, we should return 0 instead. Map allows us to transform the values inside a validated. It operates only on the valid case, and that's why we say that validated is also right biased. If we were mapping and there was an invalid, in that case the transformation is never applied, and invalid is left untouched. Through toValidatedNel, we are able to transform a validated into a validated NEL. Hence, given that we are in an invalid case, we can access to all the benefits from the non-empty list data type that we have seen before. The operator or else allows us to set apart distinct validated values. With it, only the error on the right is preserved, and the error on the left is ignored. With findValid, we can also discriminate different validated values. This is similar to or else, except that here, values are accumulated. Then, the type held in the valid value should be of the semigroup type class, as these values are accumulated through the combine function defined by the semigroup. Validated doesn't have a flat map operator, as either. But with the applicative builder, we can compute different values of validated that are independent from each other. This way, we can map or convert into tuples a set of operations preserving the type information and preserving their ID. Also, if we find an invalid value, then the computation won't short-circuit, as it happens when working with other data types. But invalid values encountered will be combined and returned. As we've seen before, we need that the invalid type is of the semigroup type class. This is to be able to combine these values at each step properly.
In this video, we learn about validated. In the same way as with other data types, validated servers allow for the functions and different functionality as either did, like map, fall, or get or else. Arrow proposes a unified programming model for all data types. We will learn more about those in the next series. Thanks for watching.